ko sa inyo lahat. Parang birthday ko. Pili ko na sa birthday ko ako. But before anything, I just want to thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you for being a part of this launch. It's been a while since I was back in the Philippines. It's been almost a year. The last time was October last year. And kinakabahan ako kasi, I mean, this is very different from what I usually do. I don't think I've actually had a launch like this. So I want to thank Republic Records, UMG. Thank you guys so much for making this happen. This is amazing. Sobrang salamat po sa lahat po ng sa media and press po. Maraming salamat po sa pagpunta. I love these. My friends and family. And of course, my fellow Cornerstone artists are also here at Star Magic. Maraming salamat po. And this next song that I'm going to sing, I would say this is the song that started it all for me, for my music career. And I just wanted to sing it, you know, just to kind of give thanks to this song. I'm sure you guys know this song. So let's all sing together. I want you guys to sing with me. Okay ba yun?
Yeah!
All right. I reached a point where I was almost tired of singing this song, but then I reached a point recently that I was like, you know, I'll be singing this song forever. And I'll always be grateful for that song. And I'm starting this new chapter in my career. Bagong bago, I mean, this is very different from what I usually do. It's very different from Dial Suyo. So now I want to welcome you guys to the trilogy, the Heartbreak Trilogy. I'll be singing 1, 2, 3 for the very first time. And I just want to again thanks to everyone that's been a part of this whole journey, this whole project. I know it's been tough. Wala ako dito sa Pinas, so medyo naging mahirap yung pag-release namin ito, you know, being able to do this. Actually, it's perfect timing. Nandito ako ngayon sa Pinas and sobrang rush. It was rush. If you guys don't even know, like, we rushed everything just to make sure that we're able to do this. And without you guys being here tonight, this wouldn't be possible. So I just wanna thank you all. Very first song. I wrote these three songs. Don't get me wrong. I know it's a heartbreak trilogy, but let's just say na may mga bagay na pagdadaanan mo, may mga bagay na rin na maririnig mo, and it all just comes together. And somehow you're able to create these songs. And minsan mas ma For me at least, mas maayos kung nasusulat yung mga bagay na masakit pag okay na ako, pag masaya na ako. Kasi minsan parang feeling ko, si Moira, sabi ni Moira, nakikita kita. So meaning, mas masakit pag ginagdadaanan ba? No, for me, I think my experience with these three songs, I was actually in a good space. I was in a good headspace, you know, and then I created these three songs. I just happened to be in that creative space, and I wrote these three songs in 2 days. I think my handler from Cornerstone was actually there, like 24/7, as when I was writing these three songs. The first song, ito yung parte ng Heartbreak Trilogy. It's the phases of a breakup. Yung first song, it still sounds happy, right? It still sounds like it's upbeat. Medyo okay pa yung relationship. Kailangan mo lang ng reassurance na basta talang kung tayo, I'm good. The next song, ito na yung meron ng hindi tama yung nangyayari. Parang alam mo na hindi ka na sinasama, hindi ka na pinakikilala, hindi ka na... Ito yung andyan ka pa pero parang hindi ka na niya nakikita. I'm sure marami na nakaka-relate dito. This one is called Kahit Di Mo Ako Nakikita. Anong gusto niyo? Yung una o yung pangalawa? Ako? No, but let's hear from you guys in the front. Anong mas gusto niyo? Yung first o yung second? Yung pangalawa? Yung mas masakit? Mas nakaka-relate ba kayo doon?
Sa
parang may nakaka-relate dito. It's weird, actually. Dati, this was my favorite nung sa tatlo, yung pinaka-favorite ko. Dahil feeling ko, ito yung ano yun, I think each song has its own line that is very hurtful. Yung sa unang kanta, yung uh, Naisip ko yung lyrics eh. Basta meron lyrics every song. Mamaya na nga. But before I do this next song, I just want to do my thank yous, proper thank yous. Whereas this three songs, not thinking about how many streams or how many listeners or fans that are going to be able to listen to it. I wrote these three songs knowing that there are people out there that need to hear this song. And so, para sa mga taong kailangan itong mga kantang to, sana gustuhan nyo at mahanap nyo ang peace and healing. And no matter how many times you say, okay lang ako, magiging okay ka din at some point.
Congratulations, man. Thank you so much for gracing us with your beautiful performance, your beautiful voice, all the way from the US.
Yes.
Igor, anong pinaka namimiss mo dito sa Pinas? It's been 8 months.
Honestly, besides all of you guys, besides the people, food!
Pagkain!
As in, parang nanaba na ako dito, hindi ako nabibiro.
Namiss
ko yung goto. Kasi pwede ka, I can eat goto in the States, but it's not the same. I love lugaw. Lugaw is my favorite. Isa sa mga namiss ko. Tosilog.
Every day ko siyang kinakain. Ever since I arrived, that's my food. Alam mo, Inigo. Si Inigo, ladies and gentlemen, nandito kami sa backstage, sa dressing room area natin. Tapos, pagdating ko, ako what? Topless! Tapos, may session pala. Magpapatattoo! Nagpapatattoo
ko lang dito sa ano sa libya.
Sabi ko sa kanya, sa sobrang manhit niya, nagpatattoo siya bago mag-perform.
Sakit eh.
Okay, speaking of which, ano yung favorite song mo dun sa tatlo?
You know, honestly,
personally,
it keeps changing. I thought kahit di mo ko nakikita was my favorite. I feel like that's the most heartfelt song out of the three. Pero ngayon parang every time pinaperform ko yung basta alam kong tayo, parang mas, I don't know, I just feel like that song has become so much, it's I enjoy performing basta alam kong tayo. Feeling ko yun yung mas nakakabanik ako sa mga listeners. Kasi I feel, to be honest, I still feel scared performing these type of songs because I'm so used to doing that. You know what I mean? So this is very different from what I do.
Yeah.
And I feel like basta alam kong tayo is the one that kind of sets the middle grounds for me.
And speaking of which, syempre, it's a heartbreak trilogy. And ano naman yung advice mo sa mga nag-move on dyan,
wait lang, sino ba dito nag-move on? Turo niyo yung kaibigan niyo nag-move on. Gusto ko yung may mga mentum as yung kamay nyo. Be proud. Hindi, advice ko. Advice ko siyempre ano, to be honest, iba-iba naman tayong lahat. May mga taong walwalang therapy nila. May mga tao, talking is their therapy. There's people that music is their therapy. And sometimes in your darkest moments, doon mo mahanap yung mga bagay na hindi mo alam na kaya mo palang gawin. So honestly, try and venture out, do something that you've never done before so that you forget who you were with that person para mahanap mo yung bagong ikaw.
Bagong ikaw. So, eto naman. We've gone through the heartbreak trilogy, we've gone through the Dahil Sayos, the Catching Feelings. Kailan naman yung love trilogy?
Yun.
Experience pa namin yun.
Abangan natin ang love trilogy. It's actually a love album.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, once again, Inigo Pascual.
Thank you guys.
Palakpakan naman po natin. With that, let's invite on stage the Republic Records Philippines label manager, Ms. Pauline Soberano.
Guys, totoo, super talaga yung pangalan niya. Super!
Anyway, thank you all. I don't know.